Morning, dear children. How are you all?
Yes,
you all are excellent. Thank you. Now, today we are taking
Homings.
From Homings, that is lesson number 4, in the Kingdom of Fools. In the Kingdom of Fools, written by A.K. Ramanujan. A.K. Ramanujan. Born on 16th March 1929 and died on 23rd of July 1993, was the Indian poet and scholar of Indian literature who wrote in both English and Kannada language. Ramanujan was a poet, scholar, who translator and playwright. His academic research ran across 5 languages. Those languages: English, Kannada, Tamil, Telugu, and Sanskrit. He published works on both classical and modern variants of his literature and argued strongly for giving local, non-standard dialects of their use. Yes, sir. He was awarded the Sahitya Academic Award posthumously in 1999. After his death, after I think so 1993, he was dead, and in 1999, he got awarded in 1999 for his collection of the poems, The Collected Poems. Here, the author about A.K. Ramanujan.
Yes, now just now we heard about our author in the Kingdom of Fools. What is the theme of this story? See, the title only we can understand. In the Kingdom of Fools. Fools, the A means in that kingdom, means in that area, in that complete place, in that kingdom, all people, with including the king and the ministers, are idiots. Were idiots. So, what is the theme of the story? The main theme of the story is here. See here, the wisdom is worshipped. Wisdom. If you have the wisdom, wisdom is worshipped everywhere. When foolishness. Foolishness is our greatest enemy. When our foolishness is our greatest enemy, there the wisdom works. Enemy, with the help of wisdom, we can make a difference between right and wrong. Wisdom lives with us and never dies. Wisdom never dies. Even if we leave this world, we leave this world, obviously, the wise people are worshipped. All the wise people are worshipped everywhere. So, in the Kingdom of Fools, which are the main character? Main characters are the king, the minister, the guru, and disciple. Guru and disciple. Okay, now the short summary I will give you about this lesson is that the guru and the disciple. Once, in that kingdom, I said that the kings and minister and all the people were very idiots, they were foolish. So, once the guru and his disciple entered in the kingdom, and when they saw that everywhere, you know, a daytime, everywhere calm and very quiet, and they were feeling very hungry. But as it is, when the evening starts, then all the people started got up from there and they started their work as if. One thing is there, this kingdom, the king of this kingdom has have changed that night. They have decided that night could be the day and the day could be night. Means they have changed this day into night and night into day. Means all the work which they used to do in the morning, in the daytime, they had decided we will do all that work. They had decided to do all the work at night. And the whole day they slept. So in this way, they had decided night would change into day, and the day would change into night. And that time, just now I said that guru and a disciple entered, and they saw that early in the morning, the daytime always slept. Even you know, they had given the training to the all the animals and birds everywhere come and point. And this, then evening time, then they understood that the guru understood that what is this? Everything is changed. This, I think so, this is very full kingdom. But you know, there, then guru said that it is not good to be here, no longer to be here, to stay here. Then he decided, he left that place, but his disciple, Guru's disciple was not angry with this. He said that, Guru, you go, it is here, I will stay here. Because he saw that, do, what is meant by do, you know, there are all the things were getting in one guru. Anything, if you want to take bananas, if you want to take any table items, if you want to take oranges and all the cost of that kingdom, in that kingdom, was getting in one guru. Means very cheap amount, very small amount. So disciples said that it's very easy to give one cheap to live, give one to do anything and can eat. But guru left the kingdom, that kingdom, and disciple was there only. Then what happened when they entered here? The second is, they know the disciple in critical situation. The main thing, the story starts from here. Well, once a thief broke the merchant's wall to take something from his house, and he broke his wall, and when he was coming out from that wall fell on him and killed him. Then the his brother went to king and said, who beat this wall? And it was so weak wall, and when it fell on my brother, that my brother died. So you must give punishment those who build this weak wall, and I must get compassion on my brother. Then king ordered, okay, go and call the bricklayer, those who build that wall. Then see here, he, the thief, went into the merchant's house, broke the wall, and where it was coming on, that wall fell on him, it killed him. And then the merchant said, merchant called him in the kingdom, in front of king. Then merchant said, it is not my fault, it is bricklayer's fault that he built that wall, very weak wall. It is not my fault, Majesty. Then the bricklayer had been called in the kingdom, in the courtyard, in the court. And the bricklayer said, it was not my fault. When I was constructing that wall, one of the dancing girl used to pass from here and up and down from that street, and if that ankle legs, distracted her ankle legs, guru the king, then that distracted her anklet sound. Anklets, उसकी चमचम की जो आवाज है, that distracted him. And because of that, I couldn't pay attention when I was building this wall. Then king said, okay, then call the dancing girl. Dancing girl, those days, now she had become old lady, 18, 19, or more than 70 years old. She had been called in the kingdom and in front of king. Then she said, yes, it was correct. It is correct that he was doing up and down. But that, majesty, this is not my fault. It was the fault, the jeweler's fault. That is a goldsmith's fault. He did not keep his promise and I went many times to him to get my thing. And he did not keep his promise. So the king called, again king called, then he ordered to call goldsmith in the palace. Then he also goldsmith went there. Then he said, yes, I could not keep promise of her because one of the merchant, the biggest merchant, had given me order and he had said me that you do this things within these few days, and I was so busy with that ornament, so I couldn't keep her promise. Then the king said, who had given you that order to make the jewelry? Then automatically that again it comes to the merchant. See here, can you see your children here? The merchant, that brother, his brother came and he gave to merchant that he said that, you know, merchant killed my brother. Then merchant went to said that the brick is a bricklayer is fault, that is not my fault. Then bricklayer said that, no, that is not my fault, that is dancing girl's fault. Then the dancing girl said, no, no, that is not my fault, that is goldsmith's fault, because of him, as he couldn't keep the promise. And because of, then the goldsmith said that, no, okay, this is not my fault also, because the merchant had given me an order. See, automatically the goldsmith has taken whose name? The merchant's name. Then the cycle again come to there, the merchant. In this way, you know, then the merchant said, then again he had been called in the court, in the palace, and then he said, it was he, I did not build that wall, my father had built that wall. Then he said, the king said, okay, call your father. Then he said, many years back, my father went there, he's died, he's expired there, died. Then he said, okay, that fault was your father's fault, so automatically that punishment will come to you, that is, you are his son. Then he was called. Then what happened, you know? What happened then? Then they made a stake. They made a stake and then they found that, and then finally the king passed the death sentence for rich merchant. But he was so thin. The merchant was so thin. Dubla patla sa tha wo. So thin that he couldn't fit the stake. The stake, the place where they always give the punishment. So that stake was, you know, very couldn't fit the stake. So the king ordered a fat man from the kingdom for execution. The soldiers called the disciple. Who is the disciple? Guru and the disciple, those who entered that day, you know, he was the very fat, because when he had come there first time, he was thin, but everything was getting, you know, one to two. Every time he used to take the things and he used to, and after few days he becomes, you know, he had become very fat, and he was the fattest man, you know, there in the kingdom. And who had become fat by eating a lot? Disciple was there. the disciple remembered his guru. Then who had brought in the kingdom in front of king? That disciple who were eating, sleeping, taking aram and become very fat. And that disciple was very fit for that state, for the punishment. Then he remembered, his guru was telling, don't remain here, some other thing will happen with us if you will stay here. Then you know, he remembered, his guru, where are you? Come, I am in trouble, I am in critical position, critical system, please come and help me. You know, the guru had a magical power. He understood that, yes, my disciple is calling me. And he was present there. And as he was present there, he said that he whispered something in his disciple's ear, you know, and then said he called this king aside. The king aside. And he took him aside and whispered something in king's ear. Then what he said, you know, he said that I am ready to take this punishment. It's very good thing if I will die today here, who will die first there will become the next generation, the next king will become those who will die on this state, the first will become the next king of this kingdom. And who will die for the second time will be the minister of this kingdom. Then he stopped, you know, he postponed his punishment. And he said that, king said that, okay, tomorrow we'll decide that king who will get the punishment. And this guru and disciple were imprisoned inside. Then this king thought that in the night only king and his minister went inside there, and they were inside, and the guru and the disciple were outside. Early in the morning, the king and the ministers were dead. When all the people of this kingdom, when they saw that our guru and our minister died, now they were panicked, they were scared, they all were afraid. Then they said, with kingdom and minister, all people were also idiots, they were foolish. Then they begged guru and disciple, they begged, please, you become our king and become our minister of this. We cannot live without that. After their death, the guru and the disciples were saved. See, guru used his wisdom, as we have earlier seen the theme. What is the theme? Wisdom worship everywhere, and especially when the foolishness is our greatest enemy, with the help of wisdom, we can make a difference between right and wrong. So, after the death, the people of the town begged them, disciple and guru, begged them to be their king and the minister. They agreed to it and announced that now the day would be day and night would be night, and the people could get nothing for a single dudu. And because of this, this happened. So everything changed. Night is night, night would be night, day would be day, and nothing, you will not get anything with the one dudu. So everything they have changed. This is the short summary I have given you, dear children. You read this lesson once again, very carefully, underline, as I always say you, underline the new words for you, write the meaning. Tomorrow I will come with this detailed explanation of this lesson. Thank you and have a nice day.